Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating this concept of bottle package design. We'll achieve this realistic black premium bottle design from scratch using Illustrator and Photoshop. So we'll create a design in 4 steps. First, we'll get the basic shape of the bottle from a rectangular shape. Then we'll add a glossy effect by applying gradient to 2 pieces of rectangle. Then we'll create a label, apply gradient, texture and shadow for depth. Lastly, add a title and set it according to the volume of the bottle using envelope distort option. We'll be following lots of other steps to make your design more realistic and catchy, so let's begin with the designing process. Open a new Illustrator document and draw a rectangle for the background. Apply black color to it. You can use this color code. Now we'll create the shape of the bottle, so with the Alt pressed, click and drag the rectangle to create a duplicate. Place it here and change the angle to diagonally. Now we'll change the top 2 corners round. So using the direct selection tool, select the top 2 corner anchor points and click and drag the circular icon inward. This will give a dome shape to the top. Next, we'll add edge glow along the border like this. So select the stroke color under the toolbar and apply gradient color. Then increase the thickness to 6 point and activate this option under gradient panel to apply the gradient color across the strokes. Now you can change the gradient color of the stroke. To give a soft blend to the edges, we'll add one more slider on the left corner. Double click to increase the color intensity and give little grayish tone to the middle. Adjust the sliders to shift the color position. Next, we'll add a shiny surface effect. So create 2 duplicates of the shapes. For the first one, leave the wider space on the top, then select both the shapes, remove the stroke color and subtract the top surface using the minus front option under Pathfinder. This will leave us a piece of rectangular shape. We are going to create 2 more similar shapes with a variation in size. So create a duplicate, leave a space on left side and subtract the top surface. For the third one, leave a little wider space and extract out the rectangular shape. Now, we'll use each of the shapes to give different light intensity. For the thinnest one, apply the color code #161717 and place it along the left edge of the bottom. Now place the second shape around here and we'll apply gradient color to it. Under gradient panel, remove the black color slider, then double click on the gray slider and choose RGB color. Here, we'll apply the color code #A1A5B8. Then add 2 more sliders on both ends with the same color and give them a little darker tone. Now using the gradient tool, adjust the direction of the gradient color. Next, bring in the third shape and apply dark gray color using the color code #202528. After this, we are going to cut out the top pointed regions. So select all the 3 shapes and choose knife tool. Now to give a cut, just click and drag where you want to give the division. This way, you can delete out the unwanted pieces. Make sure to remove the extra anchor points using the delete anchor point tool. And using the die selection tool, edge the vertices to give a narrow curve and on the top. Now, we'll select the base shape and create a duplicate using the keyboard shortcut Command-Ctrl-C to copy and Command-Ctrl-F to paste in front. Then remove the stroke color. We'll use this shape to hide out some portion of the edge glow. So first, scale on the size a little bit and place it closer to the edge. Now add 2 anchor points and start tweaking the shapes using the direct selection tool. This way we are hiding some portion of the top region. Next, we are going to create the label for the bottle. So select the ellipse tool and draw the ellipse. Then rotate the angle to 37 degrees and adjust the size according to the width of the bottle. Now create 1 more duplicate of the shape and place it down here. The distance between 2 ellipses determine the height of the label. So let's take a reference from a previous design and do some changes. First of all, let's increase the thickness of both the ellipse. Then shift the second ellipse little downward. Also make sure that the edge of the ellipse are adjacent to the edge of the bottle. Now using the line segment tool, draw the line segment on both sides, then select the lines and both the ellipse and extract out the region using the shape builder tool. Delete out the extra shapes. Now, apply fill color to the shape and remove the stroke color. To give a 3D look, we are going to apply gradient color. So add 4 sliders with different tones of grayscale. The light color represent highlight, gray color represent depth, and the black color represent shadow. Then, to give more realistic feel to your design, create a duplicate on top and apply a texture. And to do that, go to Effect, Texture and choose any of the texture. Under this panel, go to Sketch and apply Reticulation. We'll do some adjustments with the density, foreground level and background, then click OK. Now to see the effect on the design, go to Transparency and change the layer mode to Multiply. This will apply the texture according to the background gradient color. To edit the shadow intensity, select the background shape and edit the color sliders under gradient panel. Here you can decide where to add darker shades and where to give highlights. Then we'll create a duplicate of the background shape and bring it to front. For this, change the layer mode to Overlay. This will increase the intensity of the light. You can maintain the brightness by adjusting the opacity sliders. Next, we'll type our title with suitable font and size. Use the character attribute panel to give any style to your text. Once you have written your title, select all and group them up. Then place it over our label. Here, we'll map the title according to the volume of the bottle. So go to Object, Envelope Distort, Make with Mesh. This will open the attribute panel. Set the rows and columns to 2x2 and click OK. Now change the angle of rotation to 37 degrees and using the die selection tool, you can adjust the position of the vertices and handles to maintain the flow. This way, you can map any image or title to an object with a volume. Once you are completed tweaking the vertices, go to Object and expand the shape. Now you can apply gradient color to your title. It will act as an object. Using the gradient tool, you can change the direction of the color. Edit the color slider to give a darker shade in the middle and lighter on both sides. Then ungroup the shapes and do individual adjustments with the text. At this point, the way you use the colors determines the look and feel of the design. Now apply the same gradient color to the stroke and change the angle of rotation to minus 77 degrees. Then bring in the corner two sliders closer to the middle one. Next, we'll draw out a curve path using the pen tool. We'll use this to add a brush stroke effect to the texture. Give black stroke color and change the stroke thickness to 14 points. Then under stroke panel, choose this option under profile attributes. This will add a nice effect to the curve path. Next, expand the stroke to convert into fill object and apply a spatter texture. Set the spray radius to around 9 and smoothness to 1, then click OK. This will add a rough edge to the stroke. To hide the white background color, change the layer mode to Multiply under Transparency panel. Now, to mask out the outer region of the stroke, create a duplicate of the label shape and arrange it to front. Change the fill color to white and increase the opacity to 100%. Now select the shape and our stroke and apply Make Clipping Mask. You can do further adjustments with the brush stroke using the gradient color options. Let's do some tweaking with the first highlight shapes. Now let's add a thickness to the label by duplicating the background shape one more time. For this, we'll apply a simple gradient color. Dark color on both sides and light color in the middle. After this, place all the layers to the original position. This will add a thickness to our design. Next, we'll create the cap of the bottle. The designing process is very simple. Use the rectangle tool to get the basic shape of the cap. Use handle tools to modify the curves and pen tool to draw out additional details. Apply black color to the main shape and gray color to the smaller shapes. Next, we'll add border to the cap. So add a stroke thickness and apply gradient color. We'll choose white and black gradient color from the panel. Now, we'll edit the sliders. So add one more extra slider on the left side and apply black color to it. Do some adjustments by converging the two corner sliders and set the angle of rotation to around minus 26 degrees. Increase the stroke thickness to 2 points and let's make the stroke corner round. Now let's create out the circular base using the ellipse tool and adjust the angular direction of the gradient color around minus 75 degrees. Next, modify the base of the cap using the handle tool and scale out the size of the ellipse little bit in order to get a gap between them. Now set the cap to its original position with a proper angular rotation and arrange it to back of the bottle. Next, we'll mask out the outer region of the bottle except the part which is inside the rectangular background. So select all the elements of the bottle and group it up. Then create a duplicate of the background rectangle and arrange it to front. You can remove the fill color from the color swatches. Now select the rectangle and the bottle and apply clipping mask. And we got a nice premium bottle design inside a rectangle. You can continue adjusting the design by going inside the group and editing each element. Next, we'll add more details in Photoshop. So select a design and drag and drop it to a new Photoshop document. Adjust the document according to our vector design. Now the first thing we can do is to add depth of field. So select our design layer and go to Filter, Blur Gallery, Iris Blur. Here, adjust the angle of rotation and width of the tool and set the blur value to 8. Next, to add highlights to our design, add a new layer. Change its layer mode to Linear Dodge. Then, using the brush tool with the white color selected, start adding the highlights. You can adjust the opacity of the brush using the numerical keys of your keyboard. I have used one key to set 10% opacity. Add highlights to both sides of the edges and the main body of the bottle. Use eraser tool to erase out the extra white colors and to give a proper blending to our design. Lastly, add a new layer and pick a color from the background. Then, hide out the tiny errors in our design. Finally, we have completed designing the concept of bottle package. During the process, we have learned how to achieve a realistic look and feel using the gradient and textures. How slight changes in gradient colors give you a nice highlight. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.